All right, so here we are again with another great interview. We want to thank our guest, Mr. Anthony Andrews, for joining us today. I've been knowing Anthony for a number of years now and become good friends. So, Anthony, again, thank you for doing this for the young people, both here in the city of Milwaukee and around the world.
Thanks for having me.
No problem. So you can tell me your first and last name, please.
Anthony Andrews.
Anthony Andrews. And where were you born, Anthony?
San Francisco, California.
Oh, very good. Very good. So San Francisco, California, you went to grade school there as well, middle school?
Yes. Well, yes, I went to Burlingame Intermediate School, which is in Burlingame, California. It's about 20 minutes out south of San Francisco. Okay. And then, I was in San Francisco up to about third grade.
Okay. Very good. Very good. And then after third grade, what happened?
Well, we moved to Burlingame, and I went to Lincoln Elementary School and then Burlingame Intermediate School, which was up through eighth grade.
Okay, very good. So you, Burlingame, you played any sports when you were in middle school?
Not for any teams officially, but basketball was my number one.
Okay, very good, very good. Favorite. What about extracurricular activities? What also interests you when you were in middle school?
Really, I played a lot of basketball. I like to read a lot. I was a voracious reader. Did really only after school activities I did was we had the spelling bees. I do those every year, and that was about it because I grew up in a single family household, so mother was not very excited for me to be doing too much besides going to school and getting home immediately. So we could cut down on any trouble that could be had.
For sure, yeah. I'm sorry.
That was kind of the main focal point for her. She was very concerned. She had to work, so she'd always be concerned about what I was getting into. Not that I was a troublemaker or anything, but just the opportunity, not only for me to be doing anything, but just, anything just for her well-being. You know, Burlingame, where I was at, was a fairly safe neighborhood at the time, so there wasn't any issues like that, but just she was a worrier, so. She had strict rules.
I understand that. That makes sense. Now, Anthony, if you don't mind, that's beautiful, to have your mom committed to your education. And, many young people obviously have grown up in single family households. But it's great to hear that your mother, kept you in line and hopefully others can learn from her. Now, after middle school, what high school did you go to?
I went to a boarding school called Robert Louis Stevenson.
Okay.
It's in Pebble Beach, California, which, if you guys are familiar, is where Tiger Woods won his first pro tournament.
Okay.
And broke the record, which is kind of crazy. It's very nice area if you're into golf and you play. Got to get there and play, but that's where I went to high school.
Okay, very good. So you went there all 4 years?
I did.
Okay. All right. Very good. And any sports there in high school as well?
Yeah, the football, track, and basketball sporadically. Another issue that I had there was I had to maintain a minimum GPA. Okay. And if I didn't, usually didn't get to do certain things. So sometimes I didn't make that 3.0, so I couldn't play sports for the next semester, unfortunately.
It was a 3.0 minimum. Was that like a scholarship requirement or that was just to go to that school?
Just from my mom.
Oh, okay. Yeah, well, yeah, she's on it. Okay, well, that's good. And then what other activities were you involved in high school?
I did, besides the sports, so we had to do an extracurricular activity. So if you weren't in sports, there was a couple options. So when I wasn't playing, doing the official sport, there was a weightlifting class. So I lift weights. And then actually my senior year, I was involved in the theater production because I got hurt during football season, tore my ACL, and I did a theater production that year. But that was pretty much it, to be honest with you. And then, obviously, schoolwork.
Yeah. Is it possible to prop your phone up there just so it's not?
Is it shaking?
Yeah, like a salt shaker.
Oh, no. Hold on.
Sorry for interruption. We probably should have did this before we started it. Oh, good. He's a good guy.
No.
That'll work. Perfect, perfect. Thank you so much. Okay, so after high school, what happened then?
Well, as you know, I moved to the great state of Minnesota.
Okay, very good.
And started at University of Minnesota Duluth. I started there in 2001.
Okay, very good. Yeah, so 2001 started in Duluth. You were studying what?
I started out in electrical and computer engineering.
Okay.
And I was in that until my sophomore year. And at that time, I progressed to most of my mathematics courses. And so I decided to make a switch because I wasn't doing as well. Math, I struggled with, but the physics and the chemistry I had a hard time with. So I switched to statistics and actuarial science, and that's what I finished with.
Okay. Statistics and actual science. So that your major was statistics and actual science?
Actuarial science, yep.
Actuarial science. What is actuarial science?
Actuaries actually, the main occupation that they have is they work with insurance companies, uh-huh, and they formulate their probability models for certain risk categories. So if you, say they're doing one for myself, say I'm 37, live in Oregon, I'm predisposed to certain conditions, they can figure out based on those factors, exactly what the insurance tabulation or rate would be for the individual. So they do, they figure out all, they do all the math behind your insurance rates, basically.
Interesting. Okay. So following your undergraduate, what happened then? Did you go into grad school?
Yeah, so I started a program at Minnesota Duluth called, it's a Master's of Environmental Health and Safety. Mm-hmm. And it's a year and a half program. Basically a year, you do all the classes in the year and then an internship in the summer. Mm-hmm. That was right after 2007. Mm-hmm. So my undergrad took me about 4.5 years, and then I took another year.
Okay, very good. So 6 years out of college, then what? First job?
I did an internship at a company called Ryan Construction, mm-hmm, as a safety intern.
Okay.
Construction safety intern. Uh-huh. And then after that, I started with a company called Mortensen Construction as a safety engineer.
Okay.
I was there for about a year.
So where was that?
Excuse me?
Was that still in Minnesota?
Oh, sorry. So those were both in Minnesota. And then with Mortensen, I moved to Illinois on a project and then left Mortensen Construction. Went to work for a company called Mechanical Inc. In Illinois as well. That was for a year. That was a contract. And then I got hired on with a company called Bristol Design Build Services. And we worked in Ohio. That was on a Corps of Engineers project. So we built a boiler plant at the VA in Chillicothe, Ohio.
Okay.
And then after that, I got hired with a company called BMWC Constructors back in Chicago, really Northwest Indiana, at a BP Whiting Refinery as a safety specialist. And then I've been with them ever since. I worked there for about 7 months, and then I moved out to Portland, Oregon in 2013. I've been here since.
Oh, wow. 7 years.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. So while there, are you still a safety analysis? Is that your position?
Now I'm a safety manager. So I was a safety specialist prior. And then had a couple promotions. Now I'm a safety manager.
Okay. Very good. And then has this trajectory been what you thought it was going to be? Is this where you saw yourself, coming out of college?
Not necessarily. I took a lot of risk. I moved a lot. I moved from Minnesota to Illinois to Ohio, back to around Illinois and Northwest Indiana, Chicagoland, and then out to Oregon. And I'm originally from California, so there was a lot of unknowns, uncertainties, but I kind of, when the opportunities rose, I took them, and unfortunately they were big jumps. Moving's not the easiest thing to new areas where you don't know people, but it was beneficial for me because every time I moved, I was able to increase pay, and then, when you move within a company, generally speaking, it's a large investment on their part.
as well as yours. So they're, it builds a stronger sense of loyalty between both parties. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and so, that's a good thing, right? Because a lot of people, when they're working for companies, you know, they just want more money and things like that. But there's some things that you can't really put a price on, like knowing the people you work with, you know, understanding how that company is going to react to certain situations, because life comes at you fast, and you're going to need, you know, time off, or you know, need people to work with you on certain situations. And, you know, building a kind of a bond within a company for a long time helps with those things, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, I know them, they know me fairly well, what our idiosyncrasies are. So it's a good situation.
Yeah, that sounds good. So just so the young people can understand, as far as, you know, from internship to, I mean, you're safety manager now, then what do you go from there? Like safety manager two, what's the next?
It depends on what company you work for. Generally speaking, safety manager role or safety director role is going to be, safety director is going to be usually, you know, the top of the food chain.
Yeah.
So you'll start seeing positions like, with the title of corporate safety director or safety director or vice president of safety and health, things like that.
Okay.
Is when you know someone's kind of reached kind of the top of that career arc.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of opportunity within safety. Mm-hmm. It's since I've gotten out, I don't know the exact numbers, but there's been definitely an increase in undergraduate programs throughout the country, and construction companies, which I work in construction, but there's also general industry safety, but construction companies have become more in tune with the need for individuals like myself. And then there's honestly in the arenas that I'm in, there's not enough qualified individuals. And when I say qualified, I mean people that can do a variety of things. You know, from, you know, using Word documents to Excel spreadsheets, to doing training, to being able to work in the field and collaborate with craft workers, as well as talking to executives. A lot of people in construction, they move over from the field side and do safety. And you'll see that a lot of them don't have the technical skills or technical background to do a lot of those things. So somebody that comes in, you know, with a college background, there's going to be a learning curve to understand construction for sure. But some of the technical skills that you bring to the table are going to be invaluable as well.
Okay. And then from internship, because obviously they pay you in the internship, to that director of safety or VP of safety, what is like the annual income, you know, growth look like? Do you start off with the internship at like 25, 30,000, and then what's the, you know?
Yeah, I think you know, internship you can look for anywhere from $7, $15 to $20 an hour, depending. And then top of the, so in our industry, a degree is good. It's important because to get a degree or to get a CSP, you have to have a degree. So a CSP is a certified safety professional.
Okay.
And that's looked upon very highly. It would be similar to a CPA or a CFA, chartered financial analyst, things like that, in terms of the recognition within the industry.
Okay.
You're in. So you have to have a degree to get that. So people that are, you know, with those can expect upwards of $100,000 a year.
Okay.
And then depending on where you work, you know, some companies have better bonus structures than others. You may get into a situation where you're, where overtime is available to you. Mm-hmm. And that's, you know, that's a way to make money, especially with some of the higher salaries. And if you're willing to travel, there's a good living to be made.
Yeah. Yeah.
Especially early on. If you can get in early on a travel position when you're young and you can do it, there's some money to be made for sure.
That's what's up. So, Anthony, final question. What are your goals? Where does Anthony go from here?
So, for me, I think I've thought about this quite a bit. You know, sometimes, you know, the stressors of every day, your business at work can kind of get to you, and then, you know, you get stagnant, you get bored. I think for me, you know, I want to continue to grow technically as far as the knowledge that I have of the field and my ability to apply it and, you know, be able to people to rely on me as a resource, that is very, capable and knowledgeable, that can help them in a variety of situations. But also I'd like to, you know, I want to keep progressing with the company. I'm not so much worried about becoming safety director as I am becoming, a consistent player on my team, and in my region. And I really want to, find other streams of income to, I guess subsidize what I'm currently making and get to the point where, you know, safety is something that I go and do and enjoy, I guess you can say, but, because of the other streams of income that I formulated, I'm not necessarily, so stressed out about, you know, will I lose my job and things of that nature. I think a lot of people, like you and myself, we've talked about it. You know, the job that we do, it would be nice if we could do what we loved.
Right.
And I'm not saying I don't love it, but, you know, a lot of times we get into a position and it's a means to an end. So, I would say, for me, really to get into a financially stable position, to where I'm not worried about money and things in the future taken care of, so that I could have more time for myself and explore some other things that I like to do in life, while maintaining, you know, the position that I'm currently in.
That's what's up. That's what's up. Well, this has been wonderful. We truly thank you for tuning in today from Portland, Oregon, and blessing us with these signs of hope and prosperity and purpose. And, you know, I hope sincerely that the young people that get a chance to see this and adults that may be either interested in getting into safety, never heard of safety before or anything within that realm, construction itself, may be inspired to move forward.
And thanks for having me on, Brandon. And I would say, I was thinking about that earlier, you know, safety is not the only avenue to get into construction. Yeah. I've talked to a lot of younger people that are not aware of some of the other positions within construction, production, project engineer, some of the design, BIMCAD stuff that they could be doing, possibly going to trade school and getting into the union. That could be very lucrative too, but there's a lot of opportunity in construction. And anybody that's not sure what exactly they want to do, I would definitely advise them to look into it and see if it's something that they'd like to do, because it's very dynamic. When you're in it, it can be very stressful, but it's very interesting. You learn a lot, and if you have a thirst for knowledge, it will feed you.
That's what's up. That's what's up. So, thanks for tuning in to another episode of Pep TV, here with Anthony Andrews, and naturally, we definitely appreciate you. So, Anthony Andrews, construction safety project manager. Is that a tongue twister, long one?
No, it's just safety manager at safety this point.
Man. Okay, safety manager. So if I added all those other things, that could be.
It made it sound really good. Yeah.
I was like, each title has another, you know, 10,000 associated with it. So that's. What's yep. But this has been wonderful, man. Thank you again, and enjoy your time in Portland. We look forward to seeing you. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays. Thanks for having me, sir.
No problem.
Have a good day.